Hey guys, it's your boy Naheed, back to watch another episode of Ted Lasso. This is season 1, episode 5, 10 lines. Last episode was the auction. It was really, really good. We finally met Mr. Rupert himself. I didn't talk about it in the last, last discussion. I should have, but I just completely spaced it. But fucking Giles, man, from fucking Buffy the Vampire Slayer is freaking Rupert. Wait, wasn't it Rupert Giles? Let me look this shit up. Motherfucker! His name was Rupert Giles! Rupert! Right? Dude. Rupert Mannion. Wow. I guess that guy is a Rupert. What's his real life name? Oh, Anthony Head. I'm an idiot. Yeah, dude. Anthony Head! Incredible! Incredible, incredible, incredible. Yeah, man. I'm loving the cast, loving the show, loving the where the direction is going. Love the fact that we have Roy and Jamie. Roy and Jamie, you know, they're trying to work their thing out. You know, they're trying to get this thing going. You know, they're trying to be cordial to each other to make this team actually succeed. This next episode, if I am correct, is probably going to deal with Ted's family coming, because that was the last thing they talked about. They were like, yo, his fam's coming down. So it should be really interesting. I'm really excited to see this episode, because what Ted is going through is something I've been very curious to see. And I know it's about his marriage. I just want to see the rest of it, you know? So let's get this show on the road. And I thank you all for being here with me, watching the show. It means the world to me. Please, please, please comment, like, or subscribe. Get this out there. Tell your friends I'm back on YouTube. Watch my favorite shows. Also, guys, remember, you should have seen this on your own. Remember, I'm not another means of watching it. Please, you know, this is on Apple TV Plus. You can, if you have an iTunes subscription, that shit is free. So, you know, y'all can just go check it out yourselves and watch it with me afterwards, you know, because that's how we do it out here, all right? So let's do this.
I'm sorry about this.
Don't you dare apologize. Thanks to you, we can afford to get the other car fixed. I'll tell your boss.
I hope she gets heart disease.
Hey, Higgins.
You know, the folks we mean to, man, they have family, you know, man, like, for real.
Whenever I break up with someone, I spend months questioning it, wondering if I made a huge fucking mistake. But you have really helped me to feel good about this decision, just by being you.
We still could be around for the promo shoot later.
Oh, the promo shoot that I've spent weeks setting up for you? Yes.
I would not help him. Get the fuck away, girl.
Practice canceled.
Oh, you got it. Ooh, two spin. How about that?
Ooh. Look at this. I mean, you got teeth now?
I already have
teeth. And you can talk.
Also, Miss Welton, sorry to report, but this weekend's match will not be completely sold out.
Oh,
not
damn.
No surprise. We've lost four matches in a row and we're facing relegation. I think it's all going rather smashingly.
Man, he hates this shit.
Keely, if any of the other players needed some branding work done, is that something you'd be interested in? Unless you want to carry on doing, what is it you're doing?
I'm sort of famous for being almost famous.
Excellent.
Hey man, if it works for you, it works for you. You know, if it works because, you know what I mean?
Do they wrap the fish and chips in newspaper? I read they do that here.
No, I wish. Boy, I'd love that. Have my food teach me stuff.
Yeah, that's your dream scenario, right? A donut that knows about Rosa Parks or something?
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah, him and his wife look like they got... She don't want to fuck with him from the look of it.
Why don't you just bring him over to my place and we can look at them together? Maybe we're naked.
Hard no. Thank you again, Jamie.
I have to hang out with that prick. The fact that you would choose to be with him, it's frankly mind-blowing.
We broke up. We're working together, actually. And who asked you anyway, huh?
Right.
I can see them, too. Jamie's a dick. Fuck him.
It's just that in training, Sam was wide open and Jamie wouldn't pass to him. Now, that's what I'm dealing with.
That's hilarious.
They're nice out there, isn't it?
Oh, yeah. I can make us some breakfast.
What's wrong?
Every day. I wake up hoping that I'll feel the way I felt in the beginning.
I'll keep trying.
You know I will.
What is there? I'm not trying to be mean, but like, I get it, you know. But like, what is she wanting to feel? I mean, I'm sure she feels very, very, I don't know, I'm just trying to figure that out, because that's something that's always been kind of like...
Marriage, just so, you know, so complicated.
Yeah, exactly, man. Somebody spell that shit out for me, because, like, the fuck?
You mind if I get your take on something? You and the missus. Y'all been together a while, yeah?
Oh, yes. 28 years.
Oh?
5 boys, 3 dogs, 1 20-year-old cat whose impending death will wreck me emotionally.
And I've got a cat. You guys are so lucky. For real. You have a beautiful life, man.
If you're with the right person, even the hard times are easy.
Someone called 911. Yeah, I want to report a truth bomb.
Man, this shit is, it's just good, man. It really, really is. I love how, you know, it's just, it hits on some really good fucking notes, man. Really, really does. Really, really does.
How's about you and me make a deal? You get to keep on preaching all of your yee-haw bullshit, and in exchange, I'll keep ignoring you because this team is tragic.
Bench him. Bench the. Bench him. Bench him.
Hey, Tart.
Hello, little lads.
What do you say in my shirt?
Now, next time I score a goal, it won't just be for me. It'll be for you too.
He's a little shit. He's a shit. I don't like him, man. What a shit. Bench him. Bench him. I would bench that guy. Fuck you, bro.
Tart receives the ball. Clever there. God, Jimmy. He finds space. He has Obisanya on the right. No, he's doing it himself. Oh, what a finish.
I mean, it's kind of hard to bench that guy, but I get it. You know what I mean?
Got ourselves a tie game. Nice work.
They're about to kill it, y'all. They're about to kill it. Just watch.
We're broken. We need to change. I think that's what it's all about. Embracing change.
For real.
Being brave.
Exactly.
Doing whatever you have to so that everyone in your life can move forward theirs. Oh, hey, one last thing. And I want everyone's eyes on me when I say this. Look at me.
Man, this show's really good, guys. Very, very, very good. I'm very impressed by it. Yes, look at them. They're all so happy. You fucking did it, Ted. You fucking did it. Ooh! This shit is so good. He gets to be a hero for the day. The best hero on the planet to his son.
Daddy?
Yeah?
What's a wanker?
You don't need to know, son.
That's a man that likes to be alone with his thoughts. Make sense? Let's give you a better view on it.
Exactly, it does.
I just keep thinking about the first time we met. Us being the only two people in that big old parking lot at the exact same time. Shell, there's something I could do or something I could say that would make you be happy. I'd do it in a nanosecond. But I ain't got no control over any of that. You don't have to keep trying anymore. I'm gonna be okay. Yeah?
Oh, man. Sorry for that, guys. Ted's a great guy. You know, obviously, you know, things have been very different, you know, for me and things, and I've been going through a breakup, obviously. You know, that's the thing with relationships, man. You know, you pour yourself, you give yourself all to someone in the hopes that, you know, this concept or idea of forever, you know, is alive. But that's not always true. That's not what always happens with life, you know? And life, you know, things change, people change, and then you have to just accept them for what they are, and then what happens, you know? Like, you know, one of the hardest things you can do is try and try and try and try on something, and just with no avail, it just doesn't go anywhere and it fails, you know? And it's a very gut-wrenching feeling at times, you know? The other part of letting people go, you know, it's the idea of being strangers with someone that you've spent such an amazing time in your life. Because, like, again, life is short, you know, and when you spend time with someone and you spend whatever, you're giving them a bit of yourself, that currency that I think is the most important in the world, time. And man, it's hard to let that person go, you know, just to say goodbye, because, you know, deep down, yeah, you love that person. Yeah, you feel so much and all that craziness. But at the end of the day, you yourself cannot give yourself to someone or ask someone to give themselves to you when they ain't feeling it, you know? You know, when they find something in their minds that is better or whatever, you yourself need to be like Ted and just let them go, you know? There is no point in holding on to something that's just going to fall apart down the road. You know what I mean? You just got to let it go. You got to move on from it. And it's very, 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 very big of Ted to do that and to let her go the way he did. Very hard. Because, I mean, like I said earlier, you know, being in a marriage and having a kid, you know, it's any man that loves family wants that dynamic for the rest of their lives. And when they don't see that, when it goes away, it fucks with them. It really, really does. And then they have to change the idea of what they thought was going to make them happy in their head. And that's what Ted's going through. I'm really, really happy that he won the game. He has something else to fall back on, something else to fill up his time, as I would say. Ted, you know, he's got to do what he's got to do. And I'm really, really happy that he, you know, this team is probably hopefully going to help him through what he needs to be helped through. Because the man is a saint, because, you know, with dealing with that kind of pain, especially because they've been dealing since high school too, which is kind of like even more like, wow, that sucks, that hurts, say bye to that person, you know. Ted still is out there doing the best he can, and that's the same advice I give to every one of you out there, man. Just be your freaking best, guys. Like, just be decent, because someone else will find your fire, someone else will want to bask in your greatness and deserve it. And they will take away the pain that you've once felt. And I'm pretty sure that's going to happen to Ted. Because he's such a great guy. Like, look at him. He's phenomenal. And he just wants everybody to be happy, which I got a mad respect for the man. So, to Ted Lasso, motherfucker, he's great. All right, and the rest of the stories. I'm sorry, guys. I just, you know, the ending was really good. The rest of the story, fantastic. Jamie is a dick. Fuck him. I hope he gets more run in the stick. I want him benched from the get-go. I'm so mad he never got benched. He should have been benched from the get-go. But whatever, he did help score those 2 points. The team, I'm so glad to see them work more cohesively as a group. It's going to be awesome to see that happening. So glad Keeley left his ass, and I'm so excited for Keeley and Roy to become a thing. That's going to be great. Hope Keeley gets a job being a part of, you know, helping these players get endorsements and whatnot. Fuck, Jamie's a dick. Jamie's trash. He's trash, trash, trash. But tan lines, you guys. Remember the first time you saw some tan lines? I mean, saw some tan lines? life. Life is crazy, you guys. You know, 1 minute, you're sitting on top of the world. You think you have everything in your hand. The next minute, you're just like Ted, 4,438 miles away from home, trying to figure out the next move. We're doing the next move. So, good stuff. I love you guys. I appreciate you all for watching this with me, for being here with me. I hope I'm not like, I mean, it is what it is. I am how I am. I'm dealing with some shit, y'all. And, you know, best way to put it, this is therapy for me. You know, this, me talking to you guys, talking to this camera, just putting all my thoughts out there and how I feel while I watch this show. That's very therapeutic. Thank you all for that. And I hope I helped you too. All right, love you guys. Bye. Hey guys, thanks for watching this week's episode of Ted Lasso with me. Today we watched season 1, episode 5, 10 lines. Another good one. Thank you all for spending your time with me. We would love and appreciate it if you guys would please comment, like, and subscribe. It helps out with the algos. And we'll see you guys next time. Appreciate it. Love y'all. Peace.